So a hidden feature in Numbers for iOS, that's for the iPad and the iPhone, is the ability to create forms. And forms are just another way of looking at data, and it can make it a lot easier to enter data in. So let's take a look at a simple example. I'm going to create a new spreadsheet here in the Numbers app. Just a blank spreadsheet. And let's create something that's just really, really simple. So in this case, just something to keep track of gardening. Say you have a garden and you want to keep track of how many different types of vegetables you pick every day. So you could do this in a spreadsheet and have it on your iPhone or your iPad for ease of use, but a spreadsheet may be a little difficult to deal with. So here's how you can do it. Let's create a spreadsheet here and we'll put in the first column will be the date and then how many carrots are harvested, how many tomatoes, and how many cucumbers. Let's say that's what you have. So let's shrink that table. We can take away the heading there. And we'll shrink the number of rows to start like that. Now, the forms, how you create forms, if you just try to create them from scratch, you can't use them. You have to create a spreadsheet with a table like this first. Once you have a table like this with the header row filled out, you can hit the plus button there. And you have the ability to create a new sheet or a new form. So if you don't get that there, but it just creates a new sheet, that means you haven't filled out this table enough to allow for a form to be created. But since I have created this table here, and it's just a simple table, four columns, and each one's got a header filled out, it gives me the option to create a new form. So I'll create this new form. And now it's asking me to choose a table. So it's listing all the tables available, and there's only one. So it can be a little confusing because it's just this one little table. So I'll tap that table there. And you could see it shows carrots, tomatoes, cucumbers in this little form. Before we start filling it out, let's go back to sheet. So I want to go and select this cell here, the first date cell, the only one that's there, and I want to format it with the date and time. And I'm going to hit the little I button there next to date and time. I'm going to select the type of a date and time format I want, so just something really simple like that. And also time, set that to none. Now I'm going to select these three cells here and I'm going to set those to be number. Now I'm going to go back to my table. Now the table shows an empty form here and it says tap to add title. I'm going to tap that and it's going to bring up this keyword that's specific to the format. The format of that first cell I set to date. So it's going to bring up a keyword that's specific to date. And it's got useful things like a little today button. So hit today. And it's not going to bother me with the time because I set the format to not have a time in it. So that's real nice and easy. Now I can tap down here in carrots and the keyboard at the bottom is now a numerical keyboard, not all the letters, because I set the format there to be number. So that's why I did all that the formats there. So let's say in that this day, do 2 carrots, 3 tomatoes, and 5 cucumbers are harvested. I can close the keyboard there and I can see 2, 3, and 5 on May 7th, 2018. Now if I switch back to the spreadsheet, you can see the data there matches. It's got the date, it's got carrots, tomatoes, and cucumbers. Now I can go back to the table and I can hit the plus button at the bottom and I get another record. I can tap the title there and I can enter another date. I'll just hit today again, but I'm going to use that little day plus right above to move it up 2 days. Then I'm going to carrots and say 0 carrots on that day, 6 tomatoes, and 1 cucumber. And now I could see for May 9th, that's what I've got. I've got arrows at the bottom. You can see that left arrow there? I could tap that to go to May 7th, tap forward to go to May 9th. Those are the 2 dates I've got. I've got the plus button to add a new record, and I've got a trash can to delete the current record. It shows me that there's 2 of 2. And if I switch to the spreadsheet, you can see what's there. The table is keeping up with the form. They're actually one and the same. They're showing you the same data in different ways. The thing is, it's a lot easier to enter this data than it is to go in and edit the spreadsheet, especially if you're on an iPhone. It's kind of difficult to set this all up on the small screen of an iPhone, but if you're using iCloud, you can access the same form on your iPhone as you can on your iPad. Forms are specific to iOS. So there's no way to do them in Numbers for Mac. But you will see the spreadsheet there appear in Numbers for Mac. And it's just really useful. I can add another one here, add another date. So let's go a few days in the future. And then let's say 9 carrots, 5 tomatoes, and no cucumbers on that day. And now I have 3 days there, and I can arrow through them, or I can switch to the spreadsheet version of it. Very useful. You can imagine using this in a work situation. It's nice to be able to see just one record at a time, really big characters on the screen, as opposed to this entire spreadsheet here. So if you use Numbers a lot and you think this might be useful, look into using forms, practice with it, create something simple like this to get yourself going and understand how to use it.